On this episode of Chronicles of Key, you will see my 3-day trip to Washington, D.C. along with my mom. You will see us visit various museums and memorials. You will see the happy hour that we checked out, the hotel we checked into, all the clubs and day parties we hit while we were there, and much more. Y'all stay tuned. I'm in airplane mode, don't need no drama. Everybody know I ain't about that drama, oh yeah. Oh, look at what I started. I'ma tell you right now, I plan on chilling so hard right now. Hey y'all, hey, so you know I can't start a trip off without hitting the club MCO. So, you know, we went in there, me and my mom, we went in there and we had us some drinks and we had us some food. And then it was time for us to take off to our flight. We were flying to Washington, so we flew into Maryland, Baltimore's airport. We rented a car, so we headed out to the little bus pickup area where the bus picked us up and took us over to the location for the rental car. The rental process was smooth and easy. They had gave me this new Hyundai called the Kona. Y'all, this car was so nice. It kind of made me want a Hyundai again.
A Kona?
So, when we hopped in the car, we got right into it. Y'all, traffic was crazy, but I had a jam-packed itinerary, so we got right into it. Our first stop was the Smithsonian Institution, which is a museum, but basically like space, air and space. To get into the Smithsonian Institution, you have to reserve tickets online ahead of time. They're free. Y'all go and get y'all some. This museum was actually really nice. It's very informative. It basically teaches you the history of airplanes coming about, spacecraft, anything that has to do with being in the air. They have everything you need to know here. They have models of majority of stuff that was built. They have simulations. They have all types of stuff. They had this cool old school plane where you get to go inside and see how it was made, or you know. So if you're someone who's into planes or into space and air, this would definitely be a place for you.
Oh, because this is a smaller plane, so you know, it's more intimate. It's like a jet.
This place was huge. It had multiple floors. They had elevators, they had stairs, so it's plenty of different ways to get you around.
Hey y'all, hey. Over here at this little aviation museum. It's a lot of people in here. A little bit crowded for my liking. But it's nice if you like planes.
Of course, I had to flick it up a little bit. So right outside the museum, as you can see, they had a bunch of different food trucks where they were selling pizza, pretzels, ice cream, anything you could think of. So we continue our journey of exploration, and right across the street from the Smithsonian Institution, you have a couple memorials that were pretty cool to see. And so, of course, I walked around, recorded, and flicked it up with those as well. So, of course, some of my videos are majority vertical because this was the time before I decided to do YouTube. I was just recording just because I'd be recording everything anyways. I didn't really understand the correlation with recording horizontally, so bear with me.
The girl in DC being a tourist.
Next up on our itinerary was the Martin Luther King Memorial, which is, you know, that's the memorial of memorials that you have to come and see when you come to Washington. Now, this isn't my first time in Washington, but it's my first time as an adult. But this was my mother's first time in Washington, and she really wanted to see the memorials. So here we are walking to the memorial, and this is my first time realizing that the Martin Luther King memorial statue is actually a missing pillar out of those two that we just walked through. I didn't notice that as a child. I noticed it now. It was super cool.
Y'all, I have a dream.
There was a lot of different tour groups out there, so you will wait in line to get those pictures, but you know, we did what we had to do. We hopped back in the car and we headed over to our next destination, which was the Abraham Lincoln Memorial. Now, if you come to Washington, D.C., y'all, I highly recommend you wear your walking shoes because we did a hike just to get all the way over here to this area. It was super pretty out here, but as you can see, it is highly crowded. So, I don't know if they was actually having some type of concert, I think, in this park later on. So I think that's why it was a lot of people. But just be prepared for this hike that you're finna take up these stairs. It was a lot of stairs, but we finally made it. Oh, sorry.
We made it. Yeah. Ooh.
Of course, I wanted to sit in Abraham Lincoln's lap, but they wouldn't allow that, so I just had to get my videos and my pictures. They also have nice architecture and art all around the building. Never knew that before.
It's a journey.
Here I go, put my mama to work, trying to do my little walk spin thing. Next up on our itinerary was checking out this black-owned restaurant called Stop Smackn. I heard good reviews on their food, and today they were actually having a happy hour. The restaurant was really cute. It had two sides to it. It had like a bar side, and then it had like a restaurant side. This was the menu. They actually have happy hour Monday through Friday at different times. Y'all, the restaurant vibe was on point. Customer service was great and the music was on point. My mom ordered some jerk wings and fries and I ordered me some cauliflower bites. Called myself trying to be healthy. And then I had the salmon sliders as well. The drinks were on a 2-for-1 special. Those are pretty good and strong. So after we left happy hour, there was a Subway right next to the restaurant. I was like, "Ooh, mom, let's ride a Subway." I had never ridden a Subway before. My mom's from New York, so she has. And she was just like, "Girl, you're not missing nothing. Let's go." So we left. All right.
Mama, we gotta go somewhere.
You know, we don't have tunnels in Florida. It's kind of cute.
So we jumped back in the car because around this time, my brother was actually supposed to be meeting us at the hotel we were staying at. My brother was in town from being in the Navy off his little deployment. So we was like, let's go visit him. So we did us like a quick little DC trip. So as you can see, we stayed in Hotel Pentagon in Arlington, Virginia. The lobby was cute, but I would not recommend. 0 out of 0, do not stay here. But y'all know I'm cheap and I just needed somewhere to lay my head because I had a full itinerary.
That's so cute.
The first room they gave us, the lights didn't even work. There was like trash all over the place. The bathroom was like half built and I was just like, no, this can't be right.
You can tell somebody was sitting here. Oh no. Oh heavens no. I would say. I don't even
understand. Y'all, this room is not all that. Come on, y'all can close the door because y'all are doing a mess. Yeah, this is just not what I'm used to, but it's not bad for the price, I guess. The next room we checked in, it was straight, nothing too serious, just two little beds, you know, a little TV, chair, shower, you know. The normal. So my brother, he was stationed in Bahrain, so you know it's not too far from Dubai, so he actually brought me back my first Dubai souvenir before I even went to Dubai. And this is me just showing y'all a glimpse of how I pack all my stuff in my takeoff suitcase and don't never pay for a carry-on when I travel. Next up on our itinerary was visiting the park at 14th in DC. Y'all know I love Afrobeats. This was an Afrobeats night. And so it's a really nice upscale restaurant. They have a dress code, do not play with them. They have inside eating and then it has about 3 levels of different bars and club type vibes that you can participate in.
Aww, thank you.
So of course I was really only here for the drinks, so we all got us some Blue Long Islands, but I think they actually made us order food. You can't just sit and order drinks, you have to order at least one thing off the menu. We just ordered these quesadillas, but they was pretty good, you know, just a little snack. Now, I will say this restaurant was expensive and those drinks were expensive, but we was spending mommy's tab, so we was good to go. And then we headed over to the club areas. So one level was playing like hip-hop, one was playing Afrobeat, and one was playing, I think, Caribbean music. And so it was lit, and we stayed there until my mama was tired and begged us to leave, and that was the end of that day. The first thing on our itinerary today was to visit the Washington Monument. Now, if you reserve ahead of time, you can actually go all the way up to the top. And so I was a little upset that I didn't reserve at a decent time, so I wasn't able to get it. But it was really hard. Those reservations are really tricky. We continued our journey, and we went to go see the White House. And I thought this was pretty cool, the Black Lives Matter street. I guess everywhere just about in America has a street that says that. And this is what the garden in front of the White House looked like. The White House was super pretty, and I'm a little upset that I didn't reserve tickets in time where you can actually take a tour of the White House, but you have to do that in like months in advance, and you have to clear a background check and all that. So next time I'll probably do that just to do it, but it was a lot going on here at this time. Apparently it was Gay Pride Month and I didn't realize it, so that's what all the protesting was about. This was day two and I started to realize that food trucks are a big thing here in DC. So just about every museum, every monument, it was always food trucks everywhere. So I tried this one food truck and I got me like an avocado chicken wrap. It was all right, nothing too fancy. So next up on our itinerary was visiting the Smithsonian National Zoological Park. And so it was just, you know, exactly what it sounded like, a zoo with animals. I low-key like animals. So we was just enjoying the view of the animals and stuff, getting our exercise in.
The cheetah has just got her dinner. She will now feast in front of us. Now I have found a zebra who is feasting upon the grass there.
Hey y'all, can y'all do something?
Hey,
it's trying to come out.
It's like Jurassic.
So they do have a food court there, but I wouldn't dare eat there. Everything is overpriced. I think my mom paid like $5-6 for a soda.
Hey.
Oh, wow.
Hello.
Hey.
He's got like.
Take a picture.
Y'all active.
No, a video.
Oh, show me some. Oh, swing from the tree.
Here,
Reese,
here. Ready?
He said he itching. You gotta step back. The monkey bars. Y'all, so there was a sign there that said, watch yourself, there will be monkeys swinging across. And I was like, I know the fuck not.
That thought just keeps, oh, here it comes. Thought just keeps going through my head. It's like, you're a bomb.
So after we left the zoo, I headed over to this day party I had reserved tickets for. Everything y'all see me do, I did not pay for. These was free tickets I reserved ahead of time. Y'all, so I didn't know that the Gay Pride Parade was going on. So I stumbled into a huge heap of traffic to the point where I couldn't even find parking. So I really got on that scooter and rode all the way to where the day party was to even see if I was going to waste my time. And I was trying to find us a parking spot. And then I finally found one. And so this was one of the day parties we went to. In the downstairs part, it had like a glow-in-the-dark arcade type vibe. And then upstairs, it was like a day party with a roof, open roof type vibe. So they was playing Afrobeats, of course, that's what I came for. And so it was empty, it wasn't really that many people here, but the vibes was good, the DJ was good, so I was having a good time.
I'm dead!
And so my mom begged me to take her home, and that was the end of our day that day. The next day we woke up and I decided to go to the wharf, DC, because they have a lot of stuff out here at the wharf, and I hadn't made it here yet. So this was our last day. We had checked out of the hotel and we was just, you know, enjoying our last couple hours. The wharf is so beautiful. It took us 20-30 minutes just to find a parking spot though. Like, parking was ridiculous and it was very expensive. But anyways, we here for a short time, not a long time. So we parked and we just up here enjoying the views.
Hey y'all, I'm at the wharf, DC. It's lit.
My brother ended up getting on the road to head back home, and so I just sat in this chair and enjoyed the view and sipped on my little liquor that I had. Of course, I flicked it up out there. Y'all go check out my Instagram. The photos will be up. Next up on our itinerary was visiting the National Museum of African American History. You know, you can't leave DC without seeing your roots. So we came down to this museum. Once again, you reserve tickets. It's free. Then you got to find parking. Parking wasn't that bad, but we did take a little hike to get there. My mama was woke out. Okay?
Keep up!
Thank you, baby.
For the video.
Yeah. Now, this museum was really, really nice. Like, the design, how big it was. Like, it had so many different floors and activities to do. So, of course, they have a soul food restaurant because that's supposed to be the African-American thing. And so, that was our main reason for coming here. I really wanted to try this restaurant. Now, the line was kind of long at the little restaurant because they had ran out of, some collard greens or something. And I was like, that's the main reason why I'm here. I need to try all the soul food food.
Ain't nothing ready, y'all.
Y'all, this food was not all that. Those greens were so nasty, I didn't eat it. And those who know me know I cannot stand to waste no food. Them greens was nasty. I had my mom carry them right to the trash where they belong. So we headed on out. I was a little upset that the Oprah Winfrey Theater was closed because I'm here to see everything. So we continued our journey up the escalator to discover whatever they had on the many floors they have. So this had to be my favorite area of the museum. They had this video that actually teach you a step, like you're on the step team. It was so cute and fun.
Yay.
I didn't do it right then and there. Everything in this area was like interactive learning, which was really fun. So to me, this whole museum was like very uplifting. It was very uplifting to see the great achievements that, you know, our ancestors, our brothers and sisters have accomplished. Y'all, so why I never knew that there was an African American flag, I never knew that until I went to this museum. Thank you. next on our itinerary was hitting Decades. Little day party they was having. Once again, I got those tickets for free, and it came with like a free brunch. I was a little upset they did open late, but we ain't had nothing else to do anyway, so we waited. Empty when we first got there, but you know, all I need is some music and some liquor, and I'm the party, so we was good. I was just waiting for the food to come out. So now the food had came out. I was still a little full from the African American Museum, but you know, I had to get me a plate, y'all. This food was so good. So apparently the rest of the party was on the rooftop. This is where all the sections and stuff were. So I left my mama downstairs. Got me my Long Island and I was up there, you know, vibing. As always, I stayed at the day party until my mama begged to leave. And I was like, girl, what you rushing for? We still got to go to the airport. And they kept delaying our flights. So this is us getting back to the airport. Now, this airport was low-key nice. It wasn't what I was expecting. Since our flight kept getting delayed, we was like, well, let's go try to catch the last hour or so in the lounge. They actually had a nice lounge. So we ended up leaving the lounge around 10 because that's what time it closed. But our flight did not leave until about 2 in the morning, 3 o'clock in the morning. Our flight left so late to the point where they gave us free food vouchers when nothing was fucking open to eat. This was the worst layover I had ever had. But this was the end of our trip, y'all. Bye, y'all.
Oh, thanks for watching, you guys. Heart, heart, heart. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment. Bye for now.